This is the second time I'm going to use the word witchcraft in my interviews already this week.
Magic.
Oh, sorry, it's magic. I'm with Yuval Boger, and I'm with he has a company called Y-Charge, and I'm looking at a train going in a circle, and it says, this train has no batteries. All right, so what is this magic you've got going on here?
So what we're demonstrating is long-range delivery of power without wires. Everyone has battery-operated devices or phones where they say, I don't want to change batteries, I don't want to replace batteries, I don't want to run wires to security cameras or...
It's a battery in my book. You know?
So batteries go away. And what we do is we use infrared light to safely deliver power up to 30 feet away. And what you see here on the train is you see a small receiver, essentially a photovoltaic cell, that's capturing the infrared light that's sent from our transmitter, converting it back to electricity, and then you can do whatever you want with that.
So you're not, if you're using infrared, is that a fairly collimated beam then?
It is a collimated beam, and that is an advantage because with infrared light, you can be as far as you want from the source, and you're not losing energy. If the beam spread out, then with a given size receiver, you're going to get less and less energy the farther you are from the energy source.
So this explains the question. I was talking to my friend Joe LaGreca about this, about your booth and what you guys were going to be showing, and you said that you're very efficient. And I'm like, oh, wireless stuff is charging is never efficient, but this isn't actually charging. But that's why you're able to do it so efficiently, right?
Exactly. Because the power does not diminish with distance. If you're using other technologies like RF, with every doubling of distance, you get one quarter of the power.
Right, right.
With us, with every doubling of distance, you get 100% of the power. It does not change.
Nice, nice. So explain, what have we got going up and above here? I can see two things. They look like cameras, but what are they?
So they are energy sources. They send. So the one over there is powering the train.
The one in the center here?
Yep.
Okay.
The small one over there, imagine it could plug into a socket or even fit into a light bulb. Is charging the Ring camera over there. So on the back of the sign, there's that one of these receivers that's receiving energy from that little box, and now it's a completely wireless Ring camera, never needs a battery to be replaced.
Oh, wow, that is crazy. So that's going from, you would plug that into the wall. Got ya. Can we stop the train for a second if I put my hand over it?
Did you
see it, Steve? Oh, wait for it to go again, I'll do it again.
So so you can be like David Copperfield. You can stop a train with your bare hands, right? And then once you stopped it, the transmitter is starting to look for devices to charge, and in a few seconds, the train will start running again because it found that.
So if it's looking for devices to charge, does that mean it's moving around, scanning all over, looking for a device?
Exactly. You can think about it this way. So, for instance, I have a laser pointer here just to demonstrate. Okay. If you were able to see the beam, you would see something like this, where the beam is following the train.
Right.
And when you cover the receiver, now it's going to just look around, find receivers, automatically start.
So can it see more than one receiver at a time?
Yes. So for instance, tomorrow we're announcing a bunch of partners in a commercial bathroom application. A lot of devices in a commercial bathroom, like soap dispensers or touchless faucets.
Oh, yeah. I never thought about that. That's a lot of work to keep those going.
Yeah, imagine an airport. You've got dozens of bathrooms and dozens of devices. Now you can install a couple of these transmitters and never have to worry about that again. So a single
Plus, you're not throwing a lot of batteries away.
Exactly. So there's an environmental cost to throwing batteries away, and there is so it makes it very simple. And a single transmitter can serve most devices in a single bathroom.
Wow. Okay, so I'm going to stop the train, Steve. I'm going to stop it with my bare hand. Are you ready? Look at me. Woo! Now zoom in here. So that's the photovoltaic cell here?
Right. And now it's looking for it, and in a few seconds it'll find it and start running again.
So I assume this is for commercial applications mostly, or are you going to be selling to the general public as well?
So we're selling to other businesses. You see the train started running again. So this could be a smart door lock. For instance, a door lock, it's really difficult to get energy to a door, but you can do it this way. Or it could be a security camera, or it could be a whole bunch of either consumer or commercial applications. We're selling it to vendors that want to embed that into their products and make them battery free, or being able to deliver features that they couldn't previously do because they were limited by battery power.
I can picture exactly what's going on here. Like, I've got the August lock, and I had to buy the August Connect, they call it, to plug into power right next to it so that it could get the Bluetooth signal, the Bluetooth LE, in order to convert it over to Wi-Fi to go up to the router. But if we had this, you wouldn't have to do that.
So you could have two things. One, I have an August lock as well, and I need to replace batteries every 2 or 3 months, and now I wouldn't. Now, August has BLE. Why don't they have Wi-Fi? Well, they don't have Wi-Fi.
They burn out the batteries.
Because they run out of batteries. And now you could get rid of the BLE and get rid of the batteries and make installation truly simple.
Well, I really hope you're super successful on this. If people wanted to read up on it, where would they go?
You'd go to ycharge.com, and you've got plenty of information there.
Great. Thank you very much. Oh, wait a minute. Well, Steve's asking me to ask how much, but they don't sell direct to consumers.
Well, it's designed to be an upgrade to consumer devices. So if you think about, I bought a $700 phone, how much would I be willing to pay for that to be completely wirelessly charged? Or you got a $150 August lock, how much would you be willing to pay to be completely battery-free and wire-free? So that could give you a sense of how much that's going to cost.
Okay,
but we don't set the end-user prices.
Right,
it's our partners that do that.
But I can see a lot of advantages. It's very, very cool. I'm very excited to have found you. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay.